Stay home, call relatives, do home learning. Link to the Do Now quiz is on ePraise or in the description. Pause here and get it done. Answers already on there. And so a quick bit of feedback taken from Do Now quizzes, long profiles versus cross profiles. Long profiles show the river from the source to the mouth as a simple line showing the change in height. So on the top left of the screen now, you can see a long profile showing the upper, middle and lower course from the source all the way down to the mouth. A cross profile is like a cross section and just shows the valley and the channel as a cross section at various points along the river. So a cross profile is just a cross section of the valley and the channel at any point. And now to recap on a lot of what we've covered about a river from the source to the mouth, you are going to get to watch a cheese. So there's a link to the video in the description. Watch that video, it's just under 20 minutes long. Then there's also a link in the description to a short multiple choice quiz that is based on the video. So watch the video, then do the short multiple choice quiz to show that you've watched it and you're able to pick out some of those key bits of information. If you need to go back through to find that information, that's absolutely fine. And so for our main content today, we're going to look at the different things that make a flood more likely, what we call the factors affecting flood risk. A flood is when a river overflows its channel and overflows its banks, bursts its banks. There's different ways it's described, but we're going to go with a flood is when a river overflows its channel. And there are different things that make that happen. First off, we're going to look at the human causes for why floods occur. Firstly, top left of the images you can see on your screen, building in the drainage basin increases flood risk because you chop down trees and vegetation, which reduces interception and makes surface runoff more likely, which increases flood risk. And you also cover areas in concrete. Concrete is an impermeable surface. It doesn't let water through, therefore increasing runoff, making floods more likely as there's more discharge in the river. In addition, when we build in the drainage basin, what we do is we create a network of gutters and drain pipes and sewers, which take any excess water and transfer it as quickly as possible to a river. So building in a drainage basin increases flood risk. The image on the top right shows deforestation. Trees intercept rainwater, therefore reducing the risk of flooding. So when we chop down trees, we are reducing interception and making surface runoff more likely and increasing flood risk. Finally, at the bottom, we've got a range of different human activities related to land use. If we create parkland, if we create golf courses, if we create sports pitches, all of these reduce the amount of vegetation and therefore reduce the amount of interception and therefore make flood risk increased. Even worse, if we create large-scale car parks in an area, again, building in the drainage basin, we are creating impermeable surfaces which cause more runoff and make flood risk more likely. So they were our human causes of increased flood risk. Our physical causes are a bit more straightforward. We've got high levels of precipitation, or what we would call torrential rain. This leads to saturated ground. The ground can't absorb any more water. Infiltration can't occur. So therefore that makes runoff increase and flood risk increase. We've got top right snow melt. When snow melts after a period of snow, that massively increases the amount of water in the area, increasing runoff. And because the ground is likely to be frozen, frozen ground is impermeable, therefore water can't infiltrate into it, increasing runoff and increasing flood risk. Bottom left, steep slopes. Water can't infiltrate into steep slopes. It makes runoff much more likely and therefore increases flood risk. And bottom right, any impermeable rocks like granite don't let water infiltrate, therefore increasing runoff, increasing the speed at which water gets to the river channel, and increasing flood risk. You may have to go back through the last couple of minutes of the video to make sure that you've really got secure knowledge there. But once you've done that, use this as your starting point, use the images as prompts, and attempt to write up a spider diagram of factors that increase flood risk. You'll notice on the left of this diagram, as I've done it, you've got your human factors, and on the right, you've got your physical factors. On the next section of the video, there's a model answer that you can mark yours against. As always, check the notes that you've made against the model answer. It is quite likely that you could have additional detail compared to what we've got here, but this provides a good base level to aim for. Now we're going to move on and we're going to look at some physical factors that reduce flood risk. At the top of the screen, you've got the sun shining, so therefore low levels of precipitation mean that there's reduced volume of water within the drainage basin, reducing flood risk. On the left hand side of the screen there, you've got rural areas with high levels of vegetation. This is going to result in increased interception, reduced surface runoff, and therefore reduce flood risk. On the right hand side of the image, that represents a flat surface or gently sloping surface. This makes runoff less likely because these aren't steep slopes, meaning the water's got more time to infiltrate, again reducing flood risk. And at the very bottom, that represents permeable surfaces, rocks like chalk, which let water infiltrate into it very easily, therefore absorbing rainwater when it occurs, reducing runoff and making flood risk less likely. Again, rewatch that section if you need to and produce a spire diagram showing factors that reduce flood risk, as we've just discussed. And again, model answers to check against. This is the basics. It's likely that you've got detail beyond this. Homework knowledge organizer pages and quiz questions attached as a PDF in addition to the lesson on ePraise. Get them done. I'll put the answers up for you to mark next Wednesday.